Thank you for joining the CS Board video about MetaTransformer, which was presented in a research paper titled MetaTransformer, a unified framework for multimodal learning. In the paper, they show they were able to process information from 12 different modalities that we see in this picture, which includes image, text, audio, infrared, tabular data, and more. This is inspired from the human brain, which is able to process information from various types of inputs. Designing models that are capable of processing a wide range of data formats is challenging, since each data modality is structured differently and has unique data patterns. In this table, we see that MetaTransformer supports significantly wider range of data types comparing to previous models. And in this video, we'll explain the MetaTransformer framework to understand how the researchers were able to do that. Let's start with understanding the MetaTransformer architecture. The MetaTransformer has a large unified multimodal model, which is transformer-based, which can process different modalities as inputs, such as the inputs we see here on the left, which are text, image, point cloud, which is the representation of three-dimensional object, and an audio spectrogram. And the purpose of the unified multimodal model is to yield for any input from any supported modality a vector of numbers, which is the semantic embedding or representation of the input data, which grasps the meaning of the input. The semantic representation is then used by smaller and simpler task-specific models for whatever purpose we want, such as text understanding, image classification, segmentation, audio recognition, and many more. But how can the transformer process information from different types of data? For this, the MetaTransformer has another layer, which is called Data-to-Sequence Tokenizer, which consists of small tokenizers, where each small tokenizer is modality specialist that converts an input from the modality it knows to a sequence of tokens. The transformer is then capable of processing that sequence of tokens. In order to handle a task, such as image classification, we do not train all of this from scratch, but rather the unified multimodal model is pre-trained. We'll explain a bit more about its pre-training process in a minute. So, the components we train to support this task are the small simpler end task model and the small tokenizer model, which is the specialist of the type of model we process for this task, in this case images, which is efficient because the models here are small, and during this process the larger transformer model is kept frozen. So, it can be shared to support many different end tasks. This process trains the specialist tokenizer to bring the input embeddings into the same embedding space that the pre-trained transformer is used to work with. Optionally, the transformer can be fine-tuned as part of this process for better results, but then it can't be shared. Before moving on, if you like this content, then please subscribe to the channel and hit the like button to support the growth of this channel. So let's complete the missing piece of how the unified multimodal model is pre-trained. The paper do not share a lot of information about the pre-training process, but it does share that they use the Lion-2B dataset. This dataset is comprised of text and image pairs from the internet. They also mention that they use contrastive learning approach. So what does it mean? Given the transformer model we want to train, in the pre-training process we take samples of text and image pairs, which have similar meaning, like this example for a pair. The image and text are passed via the relevant tokenizer to create tokens in the same space, and these tokens are passed via the transformer to create semantic embeddings. The embeddings we got from the transformer are different for the text and the image, but since the meaning of the text and the image is similar, we punish the transformer so it will yield similar results for them. Similarly, during the pre-training process, we can also take pairs that are unrelated, like this example, and then we'll train the transformer to yield different results for the text and image. A very important note here is they do not start from scratch at all here as well. They actually use Clip as the text encoder, which Clip is a pre-trained model that connects text and images, so its embeddings already grasp semantic meaning of the text. Overall, it is very interesting that this pre-trained model was able to adapt to other modalities, since it was only trained on text and images, and the only adaptation process is training the other modalities' tokenizers to yield input embeddings in the same space that the model saw in pre-training. Now that we have a better idea about how the MetaTransformer works, let's see some of the results that were shared in the paper. They ran various experiments to test the performance of MetaTransformer on each of the 12 different modalities, on different tasks and various datasets, and we'll see the results for some of them. But first, here is a summarized view of the results. where in blue we can see the performance of MetaTransformer, and in pink we see the state of the art performance for each modality, and we can see they got very impressive results. In yellow we see the results of ImageBind, which is a model for MetaAI that can also handle part of the modalities examined ears. If you're interested, then I created a dedicated video that explains ImageBind, which will be linked from the description. Diving deeper into the model results for text data, in this table we see results for the GLU benchmark, which stands for General Language Understanding Evaluation. And we see it gets relatively good result. Not as good as large language models, but remember that the MetaTransformer has no pre-trained large language model, so this is quite impressive. The difference between the two MetaTransformer models evaluated here is that the upper one, with the capital F, kept the Unified Multimodal Transformer frozen during training, and the lower one, with capital T, fine-tuned the transformer as part of the training of the N-task model. We can see in the numbers that the results are better when fine-tuned. Next, for image, we see evaluation for image classification task, object detection and semantic segmentation, and here MetaTransformer in its tuned version was able to achieve the best results for image classification, and quite close to it for object detection and semantic segmentation. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you again in the next video.